Amazing event coming up this weekend. Looking forward to this. It's Spare Night for the Queensway Carleton Hospital Foundation. And the amazing people behind this incredible event with us right now on Daytime Ottawa. First, we'll say hello to Melanie Adams, who's the president and CEO of the Queensway Carleton Hospital Foundation. Good
hello.
To have you on the show again.
Thanks for having me here.
You're doing
today.
Well?
Doing very well, thank you.
Great to see you.
Getting my bowling shoes on.
Oh yeah, what size? is it wrong to ask a lady what size her
very
shoes
petite,
are?
Very petite,
very petite. Very petite. Jason, he's...
You're practicing already, are you?
Jason is a size 12 for sure.
Size 13, actually.
Yeah, you were one of the event coordinators, and of course, your team, MacDonald Moussa Team.
Yep.
Best realtors in the city, right?
Well, I would never like to make that claim, but we do think we're pretty good for sure. The realtors in Ottawa are actually fantastic, so we're part of a very good group of agents here in Ottawa.
Wonderful. Yeah,
and we run the MacDonald Moussa Team with REMAX Hallmark out of Barrhaven.
Wonderful. And you were part of this.
Yeah.
And of course, we have Jan Harder here, who is, well, we just had you on the show seconds ago. No introduction needed. You have been a city councillor now, so we're...
20 years.
20 years.
This is my 20th year, and that's why I decided, I called Melanie last year and I said, you know what, Melanie, I've been thinking about a way that I can thank the people that have elected me 6 times. Mm-hmm. And the way that I want to do that is to try and raise $100,000 for the Queensway Carleton Hospital. And she said, oh, Jane, that's great.
That's incredible.
So we're having a really good time doing that.
That's wonderful. So, Melanie, are we going to raise $100,000 this bowling tournament alone? Because it can be done.
We could raise the bar really high, and sure, why not?
Absolutely.
Why not?
Before we get to the details of this amazing event, tell us about some of the good things you guys have been doing at the Queensway Carleton Hospital.
Oh, boy, the hospital, if you haven't been there for a while, we were just talking, it's almost completely transformed itself. And we really serve a large 400,000-person West End population. And the campaign that we're in right now, Advancing Care for All Ages, is really serving from birth to end of life and every acute care program in between.
Okay. Now, Jason, why did you decide to jump on board?
Well, you know, my business partner, Nima Moussa, and I, we're very, very blessed in our business, and we're very, very blessed in our community. And we were both raised to give thanks and to give back. And being involved in a lot of community events in the Barrhaven and the PN area and being involved with Jan, you know, I like how Jan just positioned this, saying that, you know, after being elected 6 times, she wants to say thanks. But really, it's us in the community that need to thank Jan. And so when I heard of her initiative to raise $100,000, you know, we were there with bells on. What mm-hmm. can we do to help? You know, the initiative that she takes in doing this, and the assistance of ourselves and the involvement of QCH. I mean, people don't realize that the center of Ottawa population based is Green Bank and Hunt Club. Mm-hmm. So the QCH serves an awful lot, and I mean, I've used it multiple times in many stitches. I'm very grateful for it, and nephews born there, and all sorts of stuff.
Yeah.
But it's to support Jan's initiative to really contribute back. And in this day and age, people are very caught up in there every day, and so there's not enough of us volunteering and contributing, and so I felt it was important to be one of those.
It's an amazing hospital, and I do myself, my nephews were born there as well, so I totally get it, right? Like, it just seems to have always, it's taken care of some kidney stone problems of mine too.
Oh, no,
that's a whole other story.
Brutal.
That was not good times.
And like Melanie says, to watch it evolve, I mean, I was a volunteer firefighter back in the late 80s and early 90s, and to see the evolution of it is just phenomenal.
Yeah.
And as a community, we're very, very grateful for it, to say the least. Keep pounding away, because you're building a monstrosity there, and it's all helping all of us.
And we're only asking people to spare a night. Simple
That's
as
it.
That, okay?
So Jan, have fun.
And have fun. Put your bowling shoes on. Jan, what can we look forward to? This is going to be a big night at the Merivale Bowling Lanes.
Well, you know, I thought about the bowling aspect, because Max Keeping, obviously, mm-hmm. he always had his bowling event, and it was fun, and I'm a lot about fun. I mean, anybody that knows me knows that. I mean, I really try to have a good time on a daily basis doing what I do, because I love what I do. But I think that the bowling, I mean, that's something that most people do when they're a kid, and then they forget about it until that time they take, in my case, grandchildren out to the Merivale Bowling Lanes and try it. And we had a blast. We just, like, all of them just had a blast. It's not age specific, I think. And now, of course, we've got some camaraderie going, and Councillor Wilkinson is, you know, aced a ringer. She says, Jen, I've got a ringer.
Oh.
I've got Christine Hardig. She's a ringer that's going to be playing. I'm going, like, oh my goodness, they're taking it so seriously. I'm going for the good time, you know.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And who doesn't like to wear bowling shoes on a on any day? Exactly. It's such a fashion statement.
Exactly. We should just wear those every day. You don't even have to be at a lane, right?
Oh, I think that's a matter of opinion.
Yeah. but so what is the cost to get involved in this?
Well, actually, it's $450 for two per team. Yeah. That gives you two games, and there's six people playing. Okay. There's sponsorship for $200 a lane. We have, and MacDonald Moussa is our lead title sponsor.
And included in that, of course, is a meatball spaghetti dinner, two bottles of wine at the table, and a live band. And we're going to have a silent auction, and there'll be many other giveaways and whatnot that we'll be doing. This is a good dry run. You know, Max Keeping had some big shoes to fill in regards to this, so we wanted to test the waters, and the response has been overwhelming. Mm-hmm. It's almost completely sold out. That being said, you know, we're still, we would love donations. It supports a great cause, so if you can't come out to join us for bowling, you know, at least throw us a donation. Every little bit helps. It really does.
And I was a part of many of those great bowl-a-thons that Max threw, right? And they are definitely missed, so it's wonderful that you're sort of, you're picking up
Well, it's interesting to see the response. You know, there's so many runs and so many other things, and this one just seems to engage. We've had very little difficulty getting engagement and getting sponsorship, and phenomenal sponsorship from REMAX to Sobeys to Independent Grocer. Lots and lots of sponsorships. Check out our website, and you'll see all of the great contributors that are help putting this event together. We're very grateful.
So, Melanie, $450 a team. So where would that money go exactly?
So Jan has made a decision this year with her $100,000 to have it designated to areas of greatest needs, most urgent priorities. So I would suggest that's going to be in a piece of equipment, and I'll let the hospital decide what that's going to be.
That's awesome. Well, that's great. We're looking forward to this in a big way. Website, what's the best place to go, Jan?
If you go to our website, wwmmteam.ca, there's registration there. You can give us a call. The JMA Event Planning has been doing a phenomenal job in putting this event together with us. It takes a lot of hands in the soup to make the good broth, so to speak. So
that's
please,
one way to put it.
We can be used both ways.
or they can contact me. Send me an email at jan.harder@ottawa.ca.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And we'll look forward to seeing everybody on Saturday night.
That's
I'm
for sure.
Forward to this
and
as well.
You can contact Melanie. I'm sure the QCH and donate directly to them as well too would be wonderful.
I'm putting you on the spot. Are you running again?
You know what? That's next year.
Yeah.
And I'm so busy now. I the mayor likes to say, he says, I can't believe Jan Harder doesn't even campaign. I said, it's not that I don't campaign. It just gets in the way of me doing my job. Yeah. So I am running, yes.
Amazing. Are you? Fantastic. Is that the first time we're announcing, or that you've said it out loud? Or?
Yeah, nobody's asked me. There you go.
It's a daytime exclusive.
Daytime exclusive for Dylan Pye.
I can tell you that's not true. We've asked her multiple times.
You're not in the media.
And Barrhaven wouldn't be the same without you, Jan. So thank you for everything that you've
done. Thank you very much.
That's for sure.
And thank you guys as well for, obviously, this amazing night. A spare night for the Queensway Carleton Hospital Foundation happening this weekend.